Hello everyone. So it's 5 p.m. I think it's time to begin. Welcome to this seminar on natural sciences from the series of events, Your PhD in France, organized by the French embassies in Austria, the Czech Republic, Hungary, Poland, and Slovakia. My name is Yann Potra, and I'm the French attaché for scientific and academic cooperation here in Slovakia. So I'll be hosting this event together with Sébastien Raymond.
Good evening.
And Marine Gobet.
Good evening, equally.
We just saw logo, but you recognize Marine later on. Today's event will be specifically dedicated to doctoral studies in the field of natural sciences. So first of all, I'd like to remind you that we organized last week a webinar on the general organization of doctoral studies in France. We hope you've seen it. If you haven't, you can find it on either the Facebook pages of the Campus France offices in the five different countries I listed before. And we'll give you the link in the chat right now. Today, we'll focus on natural sciences, and we'll have presentations by two doctoral schools. So if you've watched last week's webinar, you know that doctoral schools are the structures responsible for your PhD training when you do your PhD in France. So we have two doctoral schools, one former PhD student and one former PhD supervisor. They will, of course, not cover every possible subject in the field of natural sciences, but still they will give you an idea of how doctoral studies in that field, natural sciences, are organized. So before I give them the floor, just remind you of a few technical aspects. First of all, that will be regarding questions. You're more than welcome to ask questions at any time, but please do so using the Q&A, questions and answers, tool that should be at the bottom of your screen. And we'll take care of answering questions, so that will be either along the way in written form in the same window, or we'll ask the questions and answer the questions later on after the presentations. So all that being said, it's my pleasure to start with Ariella Briani and Etienne Gouin from the École Doctorale de Sciences Mathématiques de Paris. Etienne, Ariella.
Yeah, thank you. Hi, everybody. So just a second, I will. Okay, so good evening, everybody. It's my pleasure and thank you for the occasion to give this presentation on the possibility of the PhD grants in mathematics in Paris, let's say within the FSMP network. Okay, first of all, the FSMP, it's a foundation that gathered together all the mathematics department in the center of Paris and north of Paris. So you can see in these slides the main university that are part of the FSMP network. So in mathematics in France, in particular, there is a special rule that is that you cannot have a grant, you cannot be enrolled in a doctoral school if you don't have a grant. So if you look for a PhD in mathematics in France, you have to look for a fellowship. So that's why in my first slide, I just put here the link to the four doctoral school in the Math in Paris in the FSMP network. And usually they open their call in May and they close in the first half of June. So you just have to look at the website to have the call for fellowship within the doctoral school. Then I would like to spend just 1 minute on a program which is called Matinov Grants, which is a little bit more directed to applied mathematics in a larger sense and computer science that will be opening in the 1st of March. And usually the deadline is in May. But what I really want to stress in this presentation is the CoFundMat in Paris 2020 program, which is a program that we organized, the FSMP, in the framework of a European Horizon 2020 call. So the first call for 20 PhD fellowship will close the 13th of February. Why I want to explain in particular this program, it's because this program is directly, is really for international students, because there is in the eligibility criteria, there is the mobility rule that says that you cannot have spent more than 12 months in the last 3 years in France. So this is direct to people that arrived in France for second year of master, but not here there. There are other eligibility criteria. I will not read all the slides. In any case, you will have them. So I just point out the main point that are most interesting to explain. So just a little bit an explanation about the submission application. So the deadline before the 13th of February, you just have to submit an application which is quite light. Let's say you have a CV, motivation letter, recommendation letter, master grades, and a short scientific document when you just explain what are your ideas for your PhD and why you want to do it in the FSMP network. Then after, with this document in hand, the steering committee will do a first round of selection and select around 60 candidates. Then these pre-selected candidates have the occasion to work with the FSMP to look for an advisor and to submit a detailed scientific project. The advisor has to be a member of one of the laboratories of the FSMP. That's the only real condition. Then all people that completed the application are submitted to a scientific evaluation and called for an interview that will be held between the 4th and the 6th of May. And after this interview, a final scoring and ranking will be done with the 20 PhD contract that will start in September, October 2021. So what are the conditions of the MAT in Paris 2020 fellows? This is something that is general. This is normally the rules that apply in all the contract doctoral in the doctoral school in France. So you have normally a contrat doctoral, means that you are working. You are not a student, but you are working people. So you have social security coverage, maternity and paternity leaves, and all the benefits to be a worker, not anymore a student. Salary is around 1,500 euro for more or less for months. But this is really depends a little bit also on university and also on the fact if you are teaching or not, or some other differences. Okay, just two slides still on the CoFund program, because there are some particular activity that we do in this program. The first one is that you have a mobility which is mandatory of minimum 2 months, but this is very interesting because this mobility can be interdisciplinary. So you can have to work in a laboratory within another discipline or intersectoral. So you can do some stage or research in outside academia or international. So you sometimes can go back to your original home country and do some research there, which is also normally very interesting. I take this occasion to say that co-tutelas are allowed in this program. So if you have some contact with a professor in your university that has got contact in France, it's interesting to look also for co-tutelas. This means that your PhD is a PhD in France and in your original country. Then we have some specific activities like conference and training, specific training on professional skills. And of course, this is a program under the Horizon 2020 framework. You have some obligation. The most important one is to know is that you have to ensure open access. Okay, so just 1 minute on our laureates of our program. I want to present you two of them. So this is Simona Itinsky, which is a girl which is now in second year. No, she will finish next year in Paris, and she works on cryptographic protocols. And then we have Guillaume. Donc, Guillaume is also in second year, and he came from Canada. And his more theoretical thesis, he works in algebraic topology. So I would like to spend just, just to give you an idea of how is organized the 3 years of the fellowship, but this, Okay, I will end with another two programs that are not specific for mathematics, so that can be interest for all of you, also if you're not interested specific in mathematics or theoretical computer science. That is the this is the PhD that are done in partnership with a company and between a company and the university. This is for all France, huh? It's not just for Paris. Very briefly, to apply to this program, you go to this website and you see that company made some offers of program there. So you are normally enrolled in the university, but also have a working contract with the company. This can vary from one to another company, but this is the kind of idea that is behind this kind of PhD offers. And I will end with something which has the same flavor as the CIFRE, which is the Paris region PhD. So this is just on the region of Paris, but this is a multi-subject, so you don't have just mathematics in there. And it's also some offer grants that are carried out between a private company and the laboratory. Okay, I didn't specify the eligibility condition, but they're always the same. You have to have a master's degree and you have to enroll in a doctoral school, and normally you don't have any constraints on nationality or age. Okay, so in all the webinar, you have all the information. Normally the best way to get information in all this call is to go to the website. Okay. And that's all I wanted to share with you.
Thank you, Ariella. So now we'll give the floor to Marc Crétin from the Doctoral School Sciences Chimiques Ballard at Université de Montpellier.
Yeah, thank you. Would like to share my screen. Okay, it's okay for everyone. Okay, so good evening, everyone. So before to start, I would like to thank the organization committee for their kind invitation and for participating to this webinar and for giving us the opportunity to present our doctoral school in chemical sciences. So the doctoral school Sciences Chimiques Ballard in French is one of the 17 doctoral schools of the University of Montpellier. So Montpellier is located in the south of France, nearby the Mediterranean Sea, with a nice climate and a whole tradition concerning education. So in the first part of the presentation, I will first give you information about the scientific environment, and especially in the field of chemistry at Montpellier University. And in the second part, I will focus on our doctoral school, the community, and how it works if you want to start a PhD with us. And hence, I will detail some specific action of the school to convince you to join us. Why not? So in Montpellier we have an academic tradition since the middle ages. This year the medical school celebrated its 800th birthday, which makes it the oldest in activity in Europe. And we have also a past rich in the history of chemists with Ballard for the discovery of bromide, Gerard for the synthesis of acetyl salicylic acid, and Max Mousseron associated to the company Sanofi. So in Montpellier, you will find on the same campus dedicated to master engineers and PhD students, the Ballard Training Training Pole and the BALA Research Pole, which is a great advantage to for communication with supervisor and researcher and so on. So then, and to summarize, you will find in Montpellier the largest community of chemists outside Paris, with more than around 1,000 collaborators, 350 researchers, professors and associated professors, more than 300 PhD, postdoc and scientific visitors with an important technical staff. And concerning the cycle bachelor, master and doctorate, we have around 3,000 students. So we have many startups coming from Montpellier research, especially in health science, with two drugs on the market. In the field of energy, also we have some company startup for working at the production of clean hydrogen by electrolysis. Startup in the field of cosmetic and perfumes, or dedicated to the development of know-how in the field of synthesis, also for specific surface functionalization. So as you can see, we have a very large panel in the field of chemistry, and because the doctoral school is backed by seven laboratories which are covering quite all of the chemical sciences. So you will have laboratory dedicated to biomolecules like EBMM, from the molecule to the material and process for ICGM and IEM. For separative science in chemistry, for ICSM, for nuclear sciences, but not only, for COA, or green chemistry with the laboratory Kim Hecker. And the doctoral school is for sure baked with three institutions: the University of Montpellier, the Montpellier Graduate School of Chemistry, and IMT, which is a graduate school, Mindalès, dedicated to material and processes. So if you choose to prepare a PhD in our doctoral school, you will have the opportunity to get one of these three mentions: chemistry and physical chemistry of materials, biomolecular engineering, or separative chemistry, materials and processes, because of the field of expertise of these seven laboratories. So for sure, we have an interaction with other doctoral school for mutualization of training and mutual exchanges of practices and action in favor of PhD. So we are in interaction with the network of the 17 doctoral school in chemistry at the national level. So we will find information by following this link. But we are also in interaction with the seven doctoral schools from Montpellier University in biological science, environmental science, mechanics, physics, and so on. So we will you will find a great environment to prepare your PhD. And concerning the effectives, we have around 250 PhD students with a good mixing, more than 30 nationalities, and around 40% of foreign students. So now you have to know something about if you want to prepare your PhD in the Ballard Chemical Sciences doctoral school. So before to start, you have to know that all PhD students are funded, and the duration of a French PhD is 3 years. So how to find funding? The best way is to visit the website of the Associated Laboratories. You will easily find the website of IBMM, ICGM, ICSM, IEM, and so on. Also visit the website of the associated institution, University of Montpellier, Montpellier Graduate School of Chemistry and IMT Mindales. For sure, the website of the doctoral school, the networks of the French doctoral school in chemistry, and association which are promoting PhD, like ADUM and ABG. So the next step is to before to start your PhD, you have to make your registration, which is a very easy administrative process to get your contrat doctoral, as it has been explained previously. And in our doctoral school, you will have also every year a thesis tracking committee. The idea is to check that you are comfortable with your research topic, and you have a first one in the first year. After 18 months, the committee will check your ability to manage your research, and before the defense, you will discuss with the committee to be sure that everything is ready for the defense and to address the end and the after thesis. For sure, in most of cases, there isn't any problem. Everything is going well. But in case of conflict, the doctoral school will be here to take in charge a mediation procedure between the PhD and the supervisor. So what you have to do also is that to defend your PhD, you must be the co-author of at least one scientific paper or a patent. You will have to deliver one oral communication, and you must have follow specific training. So I would like to give you some information about these specific trainings. So you have to complete at least 100 hours of training, and each training counts for 20 hours. So you need 5 additional training to defend your PhD, which is quite easy and really, really interesting to follow. And you have 3 years, so it's not really a problem. I would say I would say it's a very it's a chance. You are very lucky because you will gain a good experiment with this. What you have also to know is that the doctoral school offers a limited number of financial aids to make short stay abroad, either at international conferences to present your work in an oral submission, in an oral communication, or through collaboration, or to attend summer school to perform manipulation or learn a specific technique. So you have to, it's a good opportunity to gain experience. So now I think we have time. I would like to give you some specific actions of our doctoral school. So we have a specific course which is named Skills for the Company. It's a training course aimed at boosting the employability of doctors by meeting the skills needs of companies. It is supported by our institution, and you will follow some theoretical training and to get business experiments, and you will get at the end a certification with a labeling and a national validation from the CDFI. We also, PhD students organize a doctoral schools day, so we have a great involvement of PhD students for this event. We propose also e-learning with the laboratory associated to the doctoral school. And you will also have the opportunity to participate to the dissemination of knowledge and vulgarization for high school students, for master students to promote the doctoral school, or for primary school students. But keep in mind that in all cases, you will receive specific training before your intervention. And to conclude, I would like to remind you the key points, the main key points, which are what you will find at the doctoral school Scientifique Ballard. It's a nice tracking of your work, a community and PhD student participation in doctoral school life, and the possibility of specific action, like participation at a specific training course, thesis prizes. You will have the opportunity to be funded to stay and work abroad, and so on. So for sure, we have a graduation ceremony, and you will find some information in this last slide if you plan to join us in Montpellier. Okay, I thank you for your attention, and I stay at your disposal for the questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much for these two presentations. We have two questions we would like to answer live. So the first one was asking whether the doctoral school Ballard was connected to some university or institution, or if it was an independent organization. So I'll answer that myself, because you probably saw in one of the slides that the doctoral school is connected to Université de Montpellier, ENSTM, the School for Chemistry in Montpellier, and IMT Mindales, so two actually three higher education institutions. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I enjoy the opportunity to emphasize that actually all doctoral schools are connected to one or more universities or higher education institutions.
Yeah, sure. We are connected to three institutions. So École des Mines d'Alès, the Graduate School of Chemistry of Montpellier, and University of Montpellier. So you will have the choice to have a PhD from one of these three institutions.
And there is another question, which is also a good opportunity to give you some info about doctoral schools in general. The first one was whether École Doctorale Ballard cooperated with CNRS.
Yeah, sure, because most of the laboratory I see are UML, I mean, are a co-tutel with CNRS, University of Montpellier, and other institutions. So we have a strong interaction with CNRS in most of the laboratories associated with the doctoral school.
Mm-hmm. So, but more generally, research is supposed to be done in laboratories, and most laboratories are actually joint institutions between a higher education institution and CNRS, or an equivalent research body. The last question was whether it's possible to do a co-tutel in your doctoral school.
Yeah, for sure. We have around, I think, maybe 20% of co-tutel. Yeah, with different, so it's a welcome. Yeah,
and I think it's also a general rule that most doctoral schools will allow co-tutel in France.
Yeah.
Okay, so thank you for these presentations and answers. I will leave the floor to Sébastien.
Here I am. Thank you, Jan. So now we will have two more presentations that will be a little bit more different than the two first institutional presentations you had, because we will ask some former, some alumni who got graduated a doctoral degree in France to give you their opinion about this experience they had in France. So I will first give the floor to Zoltán Erdély from the University of Debrecen in Hungary, and he will give you his point of view about this experience of the doctoral studies in France.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So I try to share my screen. Okay, so I hope you can see my presentation now.
Yes, we do.
Okay. So first of all, I would like to tell you some words about me, why I am talking about this possibility doing a co-directed PhD study in France. So I'm a full professor currently at the University of Debrecen in Hungary and heading the Department of Solid State Physics. But more importantly, I am a former French government scholarship holder. And I have to tell you that it's not my PhD, the first one and the only one, which was done in France in this co-directed system involving our department. Altogether, there are six PhDs which were done involving our department and the French university in this co-directed system. Four in Marseille, one in Besançon, and one in Rouen. I also have to tell you that I was a supervisor of two co-directed theses. So probably I can tell you that I have already some experiences from both sides and from the PhD student science of point of view and also as a supervisor. And I can tell you, I think, what you may gain if you do your PhD in France in this co-directed system. First of all, you may gain a very important international experience working and living in a foreign country. And you will see how people work, how they handle problems, how different systems work, such as administration, project funds, collaboration, social system, etc. And you will learn a lot unintentionally what you can benefit from later. I have to tell you that I did not recognize this when I was doing my PhD. I just recognized this much later. And I can see the same thing with my PhD students and other former scholars. And which is very important, I think, is that you will learn all of this without losing contact with your home country. And this is very important because, for example, you may double the chance to find a job after finishing your PhD. And it will make easier the decision if you want to continue your career in your home country or abroad. And you may also build an important international network, primarily in France, of course, and also in your home country. But in France, you will meet and work with a lot of international fellows too, and which is also very important that the connection between scholars is also encouraged. And you will have two supervisors, two teams behind you. And this will double, of course, the ideas, double the possibilities, and double the chance to finish successfully, which is very important in my opinion. You will have, of course, two PhDs from two countries. And if you are lucky enough and your subject is inter or multidisciplinary, you may have two PhD degrees from two different fields. For example, in my case, I have a PhD in physics from Hungary and a PhD in material science from France. And I'm not the only one at our department. Many of us have two PhD degrees. You may work with colleagues who are experts in different fields, and you will be not just a cooperating partner, but you will be the member of both teams, which is very important in my opinion. For example, in my case, I work with physicists in Hungary, but with chemists and engineers in France. And I have also to tell you that this is a very well organized and established system. You can trust in this system. It's not a new one. It's not a system under test. You won't be a guinea pig. If you just look at me, I did my PhD in this system more than 20 years ago. And this system was already a very well established one that time. And you will receive all possible help, both in your home country and in France. I was really able to test the support system heavily when I was doing my PhD because Hungary was not an EU member that time. And it was really helpful. And finally, I would like just to give you some advice if you do your PhD in this co-directed system. Learn the language, even if it is not obligatory. You may participate in the life of France and your laboratory much, much better. And you may enjoy the culture. You may understand much better the thinking of French people. And it is worthwhile. Trust me, it will transform your way of thinking, attitude to life, work, etc. I can't promise it will be easy to do a co-directed PhD, but I can promise that it's worth it, really. Thank you very much for your attention.
Dear Zoltán, thank you very much for your presentation, very dynamic, very enthusiastic about your past experience and current experience also as a professor in physics now. Just to tell to our audience that this scheme of what we call in French, co-tutelle, PhD, so in English it would be joint PhD degree, is a specific scheme in which you spend part of the time of your PhD in a foreign country and part of the time in your own institution or university. And this is a way, as Zoltán said, to be in the middle of a bridge in between the two institutions, the one from your country and the one from France. So thank you very much, Zoltán. And now I will give the floor to Marine for speaking with Miroslav.
Hello, Miroslav. Yes, we can see you, perfect.
Hello.
Miroslav, could you introduce yourself in a few words, please?
Okay, so my name is Miroslav Macko. I currently work and live in Prague. I did my co-tutelle studies. I'm Slovak, so I did it between Comenius University in Bratislava and my French university was Université de Bordeaux. And so my field of studies or my expertise is the physics of neutrinos. So in more general terms, it's particle physics. And I finished my PhD degree in December 2018. So it's a quite recent experience, I would say.
Thank you. And why did you choose France for your PhD?
So why did I choose it? So when I was finishing my master, I was a lot of people who want to stay in academy. I was facing the question where to go, like what PhD I want to go for. And so first of all, I had already during my high school studies, we had some level collaboration with French Institute. So I also learned French for 6 years. And also, for example, when it comes to my field, like the nuclear physics or particle physics, France has a lot of science going on about this. There is a lot of interesting projects about this. And after all, it's also about the contacts and that it happened to me that I had the possibility to go there. So I would say it's like a mixture of reasons.
Okay, and how did you find your French supervisor? Because I guess that can be hard sometimes.
Okay, so in my case, it was not that difficult because whoever works in a particle physics knows that it's quite common to have collaborations with several tens, maybe hundreds of people and several participating countries as the research is expensive and the machines have to be really big. And like this, it was my supervisor who already collaborated within my project with this French supervisor. And so he put me in the contact and he happened to agree to be my supervisor for University of Bordeaux. So that was actually also the reason to choose Bordeaux because it was where my supervisor worked.
Okay, and what was the added value of a co-tutelle for you?
So the added value, so definitely I can totally sign what was told in previous presentation. So for me, the most important thing is that you basically work in two environments. You can kind of get unchained from your maybe some kind of cultural rails in a way, like you can have a different context of problem solving, different context on maybe professional or personal relationships. So I understand that this sounds a bit vague, but in principle, it all makes sense because you come there abroad and you suddenly see that there are people who are not having the same framework of thinking, and you see that there is some other solutions you would not even think about. So I guess this is the added value in general.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned you already spoke some French before going, but would you say it's possible to go to France and study there without speaking French?
Yes, it definitely is. I think it's a common stereotype that a lot of people say that that French people do not really like to speak English that much. I actually have opposite experience because, in principle, once you are in the academic sphere, I'm not sure if I know any French academic which would not speak English fluently. So I had the opposite problem. They tried to be very so nice to me in the lab that I had to remind them all the time to speak French to me because I really wanted to improve as much as I can. And there was not like really so much time to be like really fluent, but I really wanted to be as efficient as possible. And yeah, so in principle, I had like completely opposite experience compared to the stereotypes which are told about French. So it's definitely possible without French, yeah.
Good to hear. And what are you doing now, and what are your projects? Are you still in contact with France?
Yes, so in principle, as I told, like particle physics is very like collaborative. So there are like this big or relatively large experiments. So in principle, now I work in Prague, in Czech Technical University. I keep on working on neutrino physics. We are searching for one really rare nuclear decay. And I'm still within the project, which is called Supernimo. We have a detector in southeast of France in a highway tunnel. And I still keep on meeting the people from Bordeaux, but also some other people from other French universities. So it really helped me to broaden this contact and to get, let's say, more visibility also for myself in this international environment.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. Thank you. Sébastien, maybe if you want to take the floor.
Yes. So thank you very much for your words and experience. Don't hesitate if you have any kind of question to ask it in the Q&A module that you have at the bottom of the Zoom screen. Just to say that we had a remark from a colleague from the University of Bordeaux reminding that in France it is also possible during the course of your PhD to give some teaching, so to be a teaching assistant in parallel to your research. But this is something that was presented in the general webinar we had last week. So if you check the presentation and the video of this presentation, you will get some information about how you can be also a teaching assistant while doing your PhD in France. We also have other questions. So this is rather technical on how to build a co-tutel. So the first question is, can you propose the second university by yourself? Yes, of course, you can. Usually it's, you know, if you want to make a joint PhD, I would say that it is quite important for your two supervisors in the two countries to know them pretty well, so that the context in which you will do your research will be rather productive and you will not lose, like, let's say, some months in order to have your supervisors get to know together. But of course, you can always propose to your supervisor, for example, a lab that you identify in France, and then it's a question of negotiation with this laboratory. So there is no specific framework for that. There is a second question. When you do a joint PhD, do you work on two different topics or the same? It really depends. Let's say that the added value of a joint PhD can be to have two complementary aspects, for example. So it means that it doesn't have to be exactly the same, but it can be like, for example, in experimental sciences, some complementary techniques. It can be like from one side, more calculations, from the other side, more like experimental. It can be combining different approaches of the same issue or the same research topic. So let's say it's really tailor-made, and it will depend on your topic and on the two supervisors that you can have and the expertise they can provide. Then another technical question about joint PhD. Do you have to defend in two places or at only one? So let's say that this is rather technical. Usually only one defense for a PhD in CoTutel. But it depends on the CoTutel agreement, so on the joint degree agreement that the two universities will be signing, and each way in which all the details will be written, so that the framework of this joint PhD is totally known before starting it. Then there is a question about the financing. It depends. So usually, as it was said by our colleagues from the doctoral schools at the beginning of this webinar, in France, you cannot do, at least in natural sciences, a PhD without having a scholarship. So what kind of scholarship can you have? This you can have the answer in the first webinar we had last week, in which you will find the details. So there will be French financial support, either from the doctoral school, the lab, or from a scholarship from one of our embassies, for example. And then when you are in your home country, this is a different question, because you should rely on the own local financing scheme for PhD studies. So another question, age restriction for PhD. I think this question was asked already last week, and I don't exactly remember if there was a restriction for the PhD. So maybe some people from the doctoral school are able to answer this question. Is there any age restriction for doing a PhD in France?
No. Normally,
for the contradoctoral from the University of Montpellier, the limitation is 30 years old.
Okay, 30 years old. So it will let's say that to answer this question, it will depend on the university and or the doctoral school.
Yeah,
they all have their own regulations for the PhD. And there is a question that I don't really understand. Do I have to make a prior contact before applying? Yes, of course. I would say that before applying to any kind of PhD offer, you should at least speak with the supervisors or with the doctoral school in order to know exactly what you are applying for, let's say. So now we are going to conclude this webinar. Thank you all of you to attend. Thank you for our panelists for presenting the doctoral schools, for the alumni to give us their testimony about their experience about research in France. I remind you that tomorrow there will be another webinar. This one will be dedicated to PhD studies in the field of social sciences. And next week we will also have two additional webinars, one dedicated to health and life sciences, and the last one will be about artificial intelligence applied to environment and the different kind of PhD offers that you can find in these areas. So thank you to all of you. Thank you to all of our colleagues from the partner embassies in Czech Republic, Slovakia, Poland, Austria, and I'm wishing you all a very nice evening, and you will find this webinar recording on the websites of the Campus France of our five different countries. Bye-bye, have a nice evening. And here you have, of course, the different contacts in the five countries plus France offices to which you can address your complimentary questions.